What's going on, everybody? Doc from Average Gamer Guys back yet again, bringing you Mission 5 of the Cartographer for the Halo Wars 2 campaign. Again, talking through in this series bonus objectives, optional objectives, Phoenix logs, and gold medal stats. We're going to jump right into this mission. I've been very happy with how this campaign's been rolling. Again, if you've watched any of the other ones, you're knowing that I'm playing these pretty much straight up. Just jumping into them once or twice. This mission I was actually able to complete and get gold just running through the first time and picking up a lot, because there is only one optional, one bonus objective. You do grab a skull for the optional objective, so if you're going to do anything, make sure you go do that. And then there are two campaign logs, or Phoenix logs as they're kind of classified in the story as we get through here. And honestly, both the optional and the bonus objectives are not very hard. This mission runs through. You have a part time of 30 minutes, which for the previous four or five missions, I thought the part times were actually really short. They don't give you a good opportunity to kind of go and explore the maps. They really push you, and even not even so much explore the maps, but they kind of even push you to get through the game without really giving you a good chance to do a lot of the optional or bonus objectives. You're going to see this bonus objective here, the only one you have to do, pop up right away, which has been kind of the same as we've been going through for a lot of them, at least for a few of the bonus objectives. So for this one, it's going to be killing air units with your Wolverines. Again, they're doing a nice job throughout the campaign. Sorry for my dog. They're doing a nice job throughout the campaign of really kind of highlighting specific units in each of the missions. I actually like that. It doesn't feel too much like it's pressed. It feels pretty natural the way they're doing it. In each mission, they give them a good, really a good intro, to be honest with you, at least in my opinion, to kind of get you used to. And I expect, again, I haven't seen this campaign at all. I really don't know, you know, how it ends. I'm playing through it. Just like you guys are probably playing through it, watching through it, just a mission at a time. But I imagine near the end, you know, we'll get more closer to a kind of an all-out battle where they're letting you, you know, pick up and fight with whatever units you choose to upgrade and use. So highlighting kind of the specific units throughout each of the campaign missions leading up to that is really neat. So I do appreciate that. So here, really, we're just going to do some base building setup. Again, 30 minutes for this mission for part-time. It feels like a lot. As I was rolling through it, I'm trying to be a little cognizant of getting close because obviously the part-time bonus can really help us. But there's not really a whole lot stopping you, especially on easy mode for this mission, to kind of roll through it pretty easily. All I'm going to do here as far as the base, I'm going to build up some energy, a couple generators, a couple extra supply pads. I'm going to use that garage to just start cranking Wolverines. And that's really it. I'll make some Marines as well, just some good all-purpose unit. Again, playing through this first time, I really didn't know, and I don't know going into them. That's why I usually play the missions one time before I record. I don't know the bonus objectives or even the optional objectives up front. So I'm hoping that's where these guides are helping you guys, because I try to cover those right at the beginning. That way you kind of know what you're getting into and what you kind of got to seek out from the beginning, and honestly helps you, you know, set up your base builds, for instance, in this mission. So I'll make a couple Wolverines. I think I ended up with seven or so by the time it was all said and done. Here is one of your Phoenix logs right at the back of the very first objective that you have to hit. So just make sure you take some units back there and grab that. And then the majority of this mission is going to be you just using your units and destroying these nodes right there. So one other just little piece of advice: keep one or two Wolverines back at your base. Every once in a while you'll have some Banshees kind of fly over. Your turrets can take care of them, but it helps you just pick up a couple of those kills, because again, they do have to get 30, and that seems like a lot, at least initially, but it's really not that bad. The Banshees come in packs of four or five, and then later on in the mission you're going to be fighting some Sentinels as well, and they're actually going to attack the base. One other additional upgrade I would make to the base, you see me just keying up a couple more here, besides just upgrading supply pads, I probably could have started upgrading. You can do one upgrade for the garage, And you can upgrade your Marines, which I highly recommend. But the other upgrade I do, and I don't do it till the very end, that I would do very much at the beginning, would be to give your turrets anti-air capability. Again, without giving too much away, and if you are watching this, just be advised, all these missions that I am covering, I'm cutting out the cutscenes for the most part, but you are going to get a little bit of spoilers. So near the end of the mission, you'll have some sentinels that'll come in and attack. Definitely if you're playing on higher difficulties and knocking this out, I think this is one mission you could definitely do it in. I would focus more on the Wolverines than adding a good mix of Marines in here that I did. But definitely take your turrets and give them anti-air capability. And then keep, I would say, about four Wolverines at your base. If you do a good mix of Marines and Wolverines, kind of like I've got set up here, you'll be fine as far as taking out the rest of the enemies throughout the map. You just get a lot of different banish. You get some Wraiths, you get some Hunters, you get quite a few Grunts, you get the Banshees. But by having Wolverines kind of staying back, you're kind of just prepping your defense for when it comes later. So this part's relatively self-explanatory. And this is actually why I think I was able to complete this so quickly. You'll see I don't do it so much here. I kind of wait for these Sentinel Swarms to come in and then to kind of voice cue me into the Mac Blast. But you're going to have to do, I think, three Mac Blasts per, at a minimum two Mac Blasts per, no matter how fast you start attacking the cores. And if you go about doing that, what will end up happening is as soon as you realize that they're coming in, they'll key you in, hey, Sentinel Swarm incoming. Don't even wait for the swarm to get there. And I'll point this out when we get to the next core. But as soon as you see that dome shield come up, key up your leader power, pull your units out of the area, and drop that MAC. What that's going to end up doing is the swarms are going to come in, and they're going to be there. But because you've already MAC'd it, they won't be able to do any damage, and the shield will be down. So you'll be able to attack the core, honestly, a lot faster. This is giving you a quick overview of just what's on the map. Again, the points are they're relatively well defended. I expect on higher difficulties you're going to be seeing more kind of stationary turrets, a lot more units. And you can see here, this is my total army setup. Again, a good mix of Marines, quite a few Wolverines, and I key up a couple more Marines here. This is probably the point where I should have, I got an abundance of power, should have powered up the vehicles. Definitely should have done that, but again, just make sure you get the grenade ability, armory. I key up advanced logistics. I don't even know if you really need that building on the higher difficulties. Definitely, that way you can help crank out some units a little bit faster. I do create a barracks here because I do see those Wraith tanks, but honestly, with the Marines having the power that they do, and having your Spartan in there, I jack the first Wraith I see, which is coming up here in just a second. Taking a quick look at this, just again, that's your objectives, your bonus objectives sitting right there. Your optional objective is to destroy two mini bases that are on this. They're pretty easy. The bases actually fall very fast to archer missiles, which is what I primarily use the archer missiles for. You've got a full component of leader powers in this one, just like you've been seeing. They kind of are slowly building as you go. So just keep that in mind. You're going to have the restoration drones. You're going to have archer missiles. You have lotus mines, which I really don't. I think I use like once. This first wraith right here, I just grab Jerome and I say, hey, dude, take that. And that actually is one technique that I would recommend in pretty much all the maps that you can. Just make sure you're using your Spartan, you know, smartly. And grabbing a tank like that is a great way to do it. This guy really... really helps me kind of clear out the ground forces, and that tank, because it's got such a wide arc, when I grabbed it, it was pretty low health. It's going to end up staying throughout the entire fight, just because I think I do a good job of kind of moving the units around, and then also healing up, and with it sitting in the back, it's not going to take too much damage. But here you go. So see, I see this dome, Mac Blast EMP comes in, and I fire this thing. And boom, it's down, and the Sentinels just come in. And I move the units in, and they're not getting hurt at all. So I'm able to attack again. I don't know if this, again, helps. It's probably shaving, I don't know, 10 seconds per time off. If I wait, you're going to see that I'll have to MAC this again. So I guess it was two. I said two or three. Some of them I think are three, but for the majority of the time, you should be able to MAC these things twice. And again, I'm doing it here. I waited a little bit longer that I really needed to right there. MAC it right away. Hit it. Go ahead. Attack these. They only usually take a couple times to attack, and you'll knock them down. You're going to have to do it for two more of them. The next area you're going to run through, just make sure you have a full army if you've kind of split and you're moving your units any other way. I kind of go in a counterclockwise motion for this one. It's just kind of the pathing I ended up choosing, and it worked. Just make sure when you come up to this next portion, this is where you're going to hit the banished base. And again, it is pretty well defended, and I definitely imagine on higher difficulties you'll have a little bit more trouble, because it did take me a little while to take this down. You probably don't need, on the low difficulty, you really don't need the energy. Not really sure why I was grabbing that. Probably because I was running through it the first time and realizing that I don't really know what the objectives are. So I'm just going to kind of do a little bit of everything, see if I key anything else up. I realized right there you saw me just power up the garage and the barracks. Again, I should have did that way earlier, because you're sitting on plenty of supplies, and especially on easy mode, you're really not losing a whole lot of troops. Here, I think if I use my first restoration drones, the first leader power you get, you should be able to unlock the capability like we had in mission 4 to get increased veterancy faster. Definitely recommend that, because a lot of these units you're actually going to be able to keep around in the battle, especially the Wolverines, and they can tear up some pretty good damage once they get a couple levels up in veteran status as well. And they're not too bad overall unit, obviously weaker to, you know, the infantry and the vehicles on the ground, but they do some damage, so having a good balance here. And like I said, I can't stress enough powering up your Marines to give them the grenade throw. Not only is it going to help me take out this base, but it really helps kind of knock out the cores that you have to destroy as well. You saw right there, I used the Archer missiles for the first time. Definitely a recommendation every time you come up to the to a base, whether it be the main base here or the mini bases, definitely use those Archer missiles, because they really will destroy. They basically take out the mini bases solely by themselves. With one shot, and depending on how fast you move, I think I was cruising through this pretty good. I obviously beat the par time by about 10 minutes. I was moving pretty quick, so you should have it every time you come to face them. Here, really, the opposition's not too terrible. This is going to be another great opportunity for your Wolverines to get some air kills, because the engineers do count. And you see, now that some of my Wolverines are kind of getting a little bit of veteran status, got some Marines in there with some veteran status, they didn't stand a chance. So again, doing the same thing you've been doing earlier, a little bit of repetition in this mission. Boom, I see that dome shield goes up, MAC blast down. Start to pull the units back in right away. Again, you get this swarm that I'm like, this is going to hurt me. Nope, no, it does not at all. You get some engineers that come in that try to heal this thing. Somehow they get some good healing done. Because they got absolutely smoked. And so does that spirit. So not a good day for the banished in this mission. Boom, you'll see again. Blue shield comes up. Leader power, MAC EMP, I guess. And then move them right back in. Start having them hit. Grenade throw ability for those Marines that haven't hit it yet. Your Spartan Slam can actually do a good amount of damage to it as well. So if you, for whatever reason, didn't grab a Wraith, or maybe it got destroyed, feel free, use his ability as well. We're going to kind of continue just the same process. Now at this point, again, I'm playing this through for the very first time, and just happened to do well enough, do good on the par time, and knock out, because there was only a few bonus objectives, one to be exact and one optional. You can kind of go either way. I ended up going, as it sits right now, to the right, rather to the left when I kind of circle back. I'm just kind of looking here at my base, trying to see if there's anything else I should do, waiting for that leader power to get back up. As again, micromanaging this large team. You could probably split your team here, The only difference that you're going to run into that I had recommended was you're only going to be able to use your Archer missiles on one base. And these are the mini bases that I was talking about. I throw Lotus mines, you really don't need to there. You probably don't need to use those at all. But you'll see these Archer missiles. This is probably the best example. These things drop in, and look at that base. It takes like two shots from the Wraith, and a couple of Marines shoot it, and it's done. Then I finish off this garrisoned unit, and we're all set for that side. I kind of screw around here a little bit. One, to kill those garrison units. Two, I'm just waiting for the mini base pad to open up. I'm going to put a garrison unit into there. You don't have to by any means. Nothing is going to come attack this or try to take it back. I do put a mini base up in here. On higher difficulties, I could see that being beneficial, especially when you're going to grab some of these node cores over here. The last one that we have left, you know, you'll probably take a little bit more damage. So that's not a bad idea. On easy, you probably could skip right by that. So just like we did for the last mini base, the second part of that optional objective is to finish off this other one. A little bit better opposition over here, but still nothing's going to stand a chance. So just kind of move your whole army in and go ahead and hit that. Again, you can put whatever you want in here. I built a garage and a barracks there. And there we go. We were just able to get up at this point the 30 air units with Wolverines. Once the Marines and the Wolverines kind of separate themselves, like you see right there, where the Marines kind of put themselves in front, you're going to get a really good spread of damage and really be able to knock a lot of this stuff out pretty quick. That base goes down relatively fast, didn't even need the Archer missiles and didn't have them anyways. So again, I'm kind of screwing around here, not sure if like, hey, maybe I need to build these bases up. I'm not really sure how long this mission's going to take. So I'm going to wait for that base plot to open up. I'm going to garrison another Marine, which you do not have to do. And then we're just going to move. I'm kind of checking just to make sure I don't miss any of the logs. We're just going to keep moving them forward, and we're going to go take this last node. At this point, too, this would be a good position. Say you've been moving all of your units, 100% of them, which you can do. 100% you can do. It won't hurt you at all. I don't know what on the higher difficulties, obviously, like if there will be units that are actively attacking your base. Like I said, I kind of recommended keeping one or two Wolverines back. On easy difficulty, they don't really seem to send very many, if at all. But at this point, I would definitely recommend, before you go to take this last one, send a few units back, because as soon as you knock this out, those Sentinels are going to drop in, and you'll see that. And I obviously don't know this at the time, but realizing it, I try to scramble my units back to help them defend, because I did not put anti-air on the turrets like I should have, and I was not ready for them to come hit as quickly. I use the Archer missiles here, and this actually does a decent amount of damage, about a fourth to the core, which instantly powers up the Sentinels to drop in and hits me with an EMP, which that's okay. That worked out pretty good. Definitely recommend that too when you go to take that node, because again, Archer missiles seem to be pretty strong. I'm going to heal up, which is probably a prime opportunity to do it. At this point, I'll have to EMP one more time. Again, they're trying to send in just a few units, but they're not going to stand a chance with what we got set up at this point. Again, I do like the balance of Marines and Wolverines. Really makes taking a lot of the stuff out pretty easily. You could put some Cyclops in here to help with the vehicles. Like I said earlier, you probably need to do that if you're doing it on higher difficulty. So we finish up this primary objective. We shut down the power conduits, the nodes, and we've gained access to the map room. So again, I'm pushing back here. There's really nothing back here. You probably don't need these supplies at all. I'm just kind of checking out the entirety of the map, make sure I'm not missing anything. And she starts to key in, and here they go. So these things are pretty strong. I think there's, what, four or five of them sitting right there. They take out my turrets, like, super fast. I've got one Cyclops that I thought I was going to use but didn't. And I do not have, I did not take my own advice again and leave some Wolverines back. Now the nice thing is I don't know what the AI will do on higher difficulties, but here they just keep cycling between the two turrets, and I have a ton of supplies, so I just keep building the turrets back and forth. But at this point, that buys me just enough time to get all my units back, and then they absolutely get destroyed. Again, I still don't take my own advice here, which hopefully you guys will. You're going to have to continue to move through this bridge portion. There's a couple sectors where they'll have these swarms of sentinels right there, and what they'll do is they'll send out a couple protector sentinels your way, about four or five, just like the base just got hit with. And I don't, again, leave any Wolverines back like an idiot. So there you see, I didn't really ever experiment with driving into those swarms. I would just recommend not doing that, because as soon as you kill a couple of them, they'll fly away. But now again, I've got three sentinels sitting at my base, and one Wolverine and a set of Marines. So finally, after I destroy these guys, I realize I should probably set up a little bit better anti-air defense. So I'm going to go ahead and key up anti-air defenses on these turrets. I'm going to make sure I get both of these turrets built, and as soon as they do, I'm going to put anti-air on them. I guess I need to upgrade that generator. I really didn't need to. At this point, I'm not really sure what's happening on the bridge. Continue to move forward, so that's going to be something that continues to happen. And I realize, hey, maybe I should take two of these guys. I should probably drive them back and sit them right here, which ends up being a pretty good idea, because I think the Sentinels come in and they attack maybe one more time at the base, and I don't really have to worry about it. At that point, with a couple set up back there, and each of the turrets have an anti-air. So we'll continue to move through here. We should hit one more Sentinel swarm of things that we actually have to knock out. So you're seeing, at this point, if you are moving through it, and you still don't have the 30 enemy units with the Wolverine, that's a good chance for you to be able to just put a couple of those up front. Maybe I would recommend maybe four or five, and they're going to knock out. I think those swarms were hitting for four. They're going to be able to knock out probably about 12 right there. So for whatever reason, again, on the higher difficulties, maybe it's a little bit harder to get those air units down with just Wolverines. That's going to be a great chance, excuse me, for you to be able to go and kind of finish out that bonus objective. And this is really the end of the mission right here. Not a whole lot doing after this. You're going to send one more Mac Blast down. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward mission. Again, it is nice only having a few, only having one bonus and one optional objective to knock out. Again, you will pick up a skull immediately upon completion. And you're going to see, boom, I hit it right here, stirring the pot. So I do grab the achievement for finishing the mission for the first time. We, again, the points, we just absolutely destroy the gold score. So again, recommend having this on easy, running through this. I did it just under 21 minutes, which is about 10 minutes under. Combat bonus, pretty good. But our time bonus definitely saved us here and knocked out a lot of points for us. So as long as you're moving pretty quick like I did, shouldn't have too much of a problem. And we did pick up two of the logs as well. And then here again, just the optional and the bonus objectives like we talked about. So that's mission 5. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please make sure to subscribe for the rest of the series, as well as the rest of the Halo Wars 2 and all the other games we play on the channel. And if this guide was helpful, please hit that like and let us know down below in the comments. You should see a video up. We are giving away Halo Wars Definitive Edition. We're giving away one code, so check the video out for that. But thank you guys so much for watching. I've been Doc with Average Gamer Guys, and we will check you next time. Thanks for watching.